weekly update as we talk outdoor, track, and field. Rod DeHaven is with us. And I tell you what, you needed a roster to keep track of where everybody went this past week. It was a busy few days for your program.
Yeah, as we touched upon last week, things got moved around a little bit. And even some of the meets that we went to, some things got moved around. So it was created some challenges. But I think largely we got there were a lot of positives that came out of the week and the weekend. And, you know, obviously want to build on that. And I think, you know, the other piece is just, you know, understanding the importance of being consistent. That, you know, we are going to travel. You know, we haven't, you know, great if you compete it well at home. Well, that's, you know, not an option. So, you know, you need to be able to deal with a lot of different things that are going to be thrown at you. And, you know, we've been very fortunate with this group, a lot of previous groups, to be very resilient in that regard. And but I still look at some stuff and it's just like, well, we need to be consistent and need to be closer to our potential. And that's going to be the key for us, you know, in terms of, you know, being able to perform well at the Summit League Championship. You know, a broken clock is right twice a day, Tyler.
It is, and I recall a week ago you and I sitting here chatting, and I threw out the idea that for the first time out in the outdoors, sometimes you're just trying to get the kinks worked out, but that really wasn't the case because of the excitement and the one less week and all those things.
Right.
Do you feel like you got what you wanted, or you feel like there's
mostly,
still a lot?
Mostly, yeah. Okay. I think mostly we got a lot of things accomplished. You know, weather was not great in Northern California, a lot of rain, you know, more wind than what we typically would see. You know, kids dealt well with that. You know, long trip to Emporia, basically turn around, get out of the bus, and, you know, compete and get back in the bus. I mean, there's some really positive things that came out of that. Two young ladies that went to Texas and hurdled, you know, great stuff there. We had some really good stuff in St. Louis. And, you know, largely there's nothing that, like, oh, wow, we just laid an egg. But I think just across the board, it's like, yeah, it's a short season. Take advantage of any opportunity you get.
All right, of what were you proudest?
Well, I think you know, you get a school record from Leah Hiskin, and for Leah, you know, I think some of the you know, she had such an incredible 2021, and it's been a struggle maybe to get back over the hump, and you know, she didn't destroy her school record, but she was still able to get it, and, you know, fought hard in the latter part of a, you know, a race that lasts 34 minutes to get that done. And, you know, pretty proud of that. You know, Ashlyn Hilliard as well, transferred from Colorado State. I think she is, you know, coming around, and I think, you know, there are a lot of things that I think all athletes, you know, when you're coming back from injury and the self-doubt and things like that, and just starting to maybe believe again is really important. You know, Brandon Camp said certainly his 150 for a true freshman. I think that's probably the fastest freshman time ever here at South Dakota State. So, you know, very impressive there. Brielle's hurdle race down in Texas, you know, really, really solid stuff on both days, dealing with a lot of wind at the Texas relays, coming back at Texas State and running well there. You know, Carson Knocker, first 10K on the track, you know, leading a lot of, you know, running by himself for a lot of that. You know, I think that's pretty impressive for, you know, a 19-year-old kid that, you know, his longest race a year ago was 3,200 meters. And so stuff, and Jackson Dutcher winning the 1,500 there. And Emporia, you know, we get some wind and some different stuff, but I think our men's long jumpers did really well down there. You know, Tristan Hanna, I think, in the triple jump. You know, the sprint stuff was fast, but, you know, some of it was a little push in the back from a gentle Kansas breeze. So we will take it and move on to the next one and see what we can get done in Vermilion this weekend.
I was just going to say, Vermilion is coming up this week, and so instead of being spread out all over, everybody will be in one central location.
Yeah, two-day meet. You know, it's going to have, the weather's going to allow us to have the meet. Certainly Friday looks to be a little bit more hospitable from a wind perspective than Saturday, but, you know, some of the stuff that will happen on Saturday, we will benefit from that. Those tailwinds, and that'll probably be a good thing. So I think looking forward to something close and very manageable travel, and you know, continuing to you know, build as the season goes on.